Welcome to Let's Do Laundry. Hey sisters, thank you so much for watching this week's episode of Let's Do Laundry. I know there's a lot of crazy things going on in the world right now. I wanted to bring to you a conversation between me and my friend where we're describing each other. She describes me as her white friend, and then I describe her as my black friend. I especially love what she says at the end. Take a listen.
If I were to describe Selena, I would definitely say fearless, pioneer, like she's not afraid to like blaze a trail, Christian, kind-hearted. She definitely is very like loving, caring, and I would say adventurous.
I would describe Jessica as creative, a heart for Jesus. I think she's got so much hidden potential that she hasn't even tapped into. She is loyal, the most thoughtful friend I've ever had. Obviously a Christ follower. What? I'm talking about your mommy. I think she just challenges me to be a better person.
For me, like, it hasn't really, because I mean, I've never like looked at you as, this is my white friend, Selena.
Thank
so
you.
So it's like, I mean, I don't know. I don't even really think about it. I don't know. When we're together, it's just like, you're my sister.
I feel the same way. I feel like, I've never described Jessica as my black friend. I never thought about the whole race thing. It never comes as a factor, like, into our friendship. You should see how cute this little boy is. Sorry. Can I show your camera? I don't know. I do think that probably with everything going on in the world, I remember calling you and just, I don't know. I was like asking you how I should respond or like what you needed me to do. I don't know.
Yeah. You wanted to make sure like I'm okay because all these people are like saying stuff on social media. I want to make sure that you're okay because I'm like, wait a minute. Like, you're my friend. I love you. Like, we've done all this great stuff together. Like, I want to make sure that you don't feel this like, I mean, I'll use the word white guilt because I feel like that's been thrown around a lot, but I want to make sure that you don't feel that because to me, you have no reason to feel that. More than anything, I feel like the thing that unites us is the blood of Christ, and I feel like that's why we're like more like sisters. We're blood sisters, but it's because of the blood of Christ, and I feel like it's like the heart that God gave us is kind of the same but different, and it complements each other.
My opinion, what unites us more than anything is just our love for Christ and our heart to both. You know, I'll tell you honestly, when I was looking into the camera describing Jessica, you know what I think is really sad? Is in the back of my mind, what I wanted to say is she has like such a heart to serve and a heart to serve God. And then I was like, oh God, don't say that because then they're gonna equate like, oh, you're saying she's like a slave?
She's calling her a servant.
I but I was like, for me, that's like a quality that we both have in common, that we want to serve people.
Yeah.
And we want to serve the least of these. And I really felt uncomfortable saying that.
You know, that servant heart that kind of like drew us together. And then you felt like if you said that, then people are going to be like, oh, she looks at Jessica as her servant.
I
like
know.
Someone would take it and twist
yeah.
it. I feel like a lot of that is going on right now.
I feel like Satan is trying to divide and separate friendships.
Yeah, for sure.
That Christ has brought together. And, you know, the Bible says iron sharpens iron. And I feel like it doesn't specify what color of iron.
Yeah.
I don't know. This is, I feel like, the heart of Jesus, regardless of your skin color or your background, where you came from, what you've done.
Yeah.
Jesus is so good, and he'll bring you great people in your life to just take each other to the next level. I don't know. I feel like you challenge me in a lot of ways, and
yeah, I feel the same way like about you. I feel like I remember, I don't know if I ever told you this, but like I remember like 1 year, you know, everyone does like their New Year's resolutions at the beginning of the year, and literally I only had one thing written down for my New Year's resolution, and my one thing was to only say things about myself that Selena would say about me, because I was like, I've been really, really hard on myself and down on myself, and she just always is like so uplifting. So that was the only thing that I had written down that year. And I think it, I know that like you're supposed to see yourself how God sees you, but I think that for me in that time, it was too like far out for me. So I needed something more tangible. And the thing that I had was like, the thing that I could use was my friend and the words that she had always said to me and poured into me. And so that's what I did. And I think that year was like a real turning point for me. So I don't know. I love you.
I love you too, friend. Thank you so much for watching this week's episode. I hope you can feel the heart behind this video. It's pretty cool, I think, to see friendship that goes beyond any racial or cultural barrier. I think it's an example of what Martin Luther King said, to judge people by the content of their character, not by the color of their skin. And the color of our skin is just like the icing on a cake. Well, actually, I think that's the best part. But I hope you like this video. I hope you subscribe to our channel so you can be notified when we have a new video. We will see you next week. We're gonna be talking about the LGBTQ alphabet soup agenda that is coming for the next generation.